Alright, welcome to another Let's Play. This is Steel Lancer Arena International, or Slay, or Sly. This is a game that I actually found in a bargain bin many years ago, and I never regretted it. It is hilarious arcadey fun, with mech combat, as you saw in that intro video there. So, I've been going through the intro movie again here, hold on. It's been something that I've wanted to play and play again, just because I keep going back to it just because of how much kind of easy, quick fun it is. So we'll do that. I want to do this through the story mode. I played through it a couple times already, but I'm going to start a brand new one. All these mechs. Basically, how it goes is this game is a sequel to the Xbox, original Xbox exclusive Phantom Crash, where you pilot these SVs or scoot vehicles, these mechs, and blow up a bunch of other people on these little arenas all around the world. There's, you know, a story, a background story of intrigue and things like that, but it mainly just serves to propel you through this tournament, international tournament. I believe in the original, in the Phantom Crash, these pilots actually did sit in the cockpit of these mechs and drive them around. But in the lore, that was deemed too unsafe, and so now they're remotely controlled in this iteration. So I have this virtual sort of environment. So let's get to it. Going to Haven. Welcome to Wirehead Haven, the virtual gateway to your rumbling playground. Oh, that's right. The battles are called rumbles. Rumbling organizer Fira registers users of this ultra-virtual environment network. Alright, let's get to it. Time to register your alias. Using your real name in Haven may expose you to data theft. Use at your own risk. So I am not going to do that. We are going to be... Rocket. Yes. Registered alias rock. Aliases may be changed at a later time as necessary. Cool. I'm excited. Now, Rocket, choose the persona wear you will adopt while in Haven. Oh, you're right, that's right. You get these little avatars that you can upgrade and, later on. They're all wireframe to start with, so cheap. I think I'm gonna do this one. Yeah. New persona wear may be purchased from the idol shops located on each server. So yeah, every location that you can battle in, hardcore server to access, has its own setup, and they're all unique. Rocket, you need to pass the licensing test for your selected hardcore server. Please note that during the licensing test, you cannot move to another server. Okay, so we've got Hong Kong, Tokyo, Las Vegas, New York, London, Stuttgart, and Cairo. I think I like New York best. Tokyo is pretty good. I think I like New York best. So we'll start there. We'll eventually have to go to all of them to complete all the different tournaments. But very well. Accessing server. After connecting Sea Haven guide Knocker from Oregon. Thank you, Rocket. Plus Register Daemons. Wish you the best of luck. Great. So this first episode, or no, may not be the most stimulating because I'm going to do some little background work to make it a little easier, more fun for us. There is a stock market of sorts where you can literally buy stock in some of the companies. So there's two of them, Solid State and Venshuno, and there's a way you can not really game the system, but holy cow, there's some lag on this server. I don't know, it's built in. It's not my game or your viewing. It's literally part of it. Pretty trippy. Anyway, so yeah, we're going to play the stock market a little bit, and I will either time-lapse that or just cut it, just so we start out with a little bit cooler stuff. First, a sudden hang-up, then the blue screen of death. What's with everyone trying to get into Haven these days? Of course, I don't mean you, boss. I'm just worried about the big meltdown I know is coming. Oh, I've introduced myself. I'm Knocker, a crazy little pixie usually found in a CPU. Okay. I'm here in Haven as an info daemon hobby yacht. If you're looking to get an intelligent chip, though, I guess I'm out of a job. Oh, yeah, yeah. So, you start out with this basic model, and you can upgrade the chip that's going to interact with your scoop vehicle as you go. Looks like the news is in. Time for day one. Results of the recent Fura world ranking. Bogeyman is the first ranker, so he's the ultimate showdown guy and eventually beat. Hot Rod put up a good fight, but it wasn't enough good to defeat Bogeyman and his partnership Joel. Ninth successful title defense. So this, the worthless dumb Pew gotta retire. Great. Well, there's no other news to speak of. Big profits for Silicon Heart and blah blah blah. More news. God of Rocks becomes Android, lives on, great. Demon Donut X returns Smash Order. Okay. And we do have to go through a battle school. Sure. Yeah, we have to take the exam, so we'll do that first. Oh my. Still pretty bad, ain't it? Hold on, hang on a second. Now let's get rid of some of these people. There we go. Off to battle school. Oh wait, I gotta tell you how to move around Haven. Don't worry, it's a cinch. Here's the scoop. Okay. Okay, so yeah, so we've got these different places that we can go, and you can either navigate normally, like if I turn this off, I could just go one section at a time, but if you do automatic, it'll just send you directly to those places. So I'm going to do Battle School first, and then I'll run that stock market thing I was talking about, and I'll run the first couple things just to see what it's about, and then skip the main nonsense and come back. But here we go. It looks like everyone's here. Give you the basic rundown here for the license test. Yes, I am. This is kind of a cool kind of interface on when you talk to different people. These different sectors will light up. Okay, Bean. Yeah, you look like the same person, but you're different. Got it. Yep. I know that. Don't need tutorials. We don't need that. We just need to take the exam. Hey, that's me. Good luck to you. Battle school. Alright, so we can go to the library to learn about stuff, or we can just take the exam. Follows the same room. So I have to go into a rumble, probably with a rental machine or something. placement SVs are marked with a skull. Okay, so yeah. Once you defeat someone, a little skull will appear next to him, so you know you've already beaten them. Seek out unmarked SVs. So, 5 machines, the boss will appear. Defeat the boss to pass the test. If you exit through the gate or your SV is shot down, you'll have to wait a day for another shot. Yeah, so the interesting thing about these arena battles is you enter these gates, and you battle as much as you want, and then you can leave at any time. There's some matches where that's different, where it's just a one-on-one, and you just have to beat the opponent, and then it's over. But most of them, you can run in, get a bunch of kills to earn up some cash, and then leave before you get destroyed. Is a good way to go about it, because if your SV is scrapped, it costs money to repair, and it could be more money than you earn from the battle, which is no good. So definitely know your limits and leave when when you're capable or when you think you might be in trouble. Yeah, take the exam. So this is pretty cool. I like the controls on this. Basically, it's PlayStation 2, and the left stick moves you, the right stick kind of turns the camera, and then your weapons, you have one on each arm and one on each shoulder, typically. You can replace them with other equipment that isn't a weapon. And so you use the 4 shoulder buttons to fire. Looks like we do have 4 weapons.
Yeah.
And this is the Karo SV, which is my favorite style.
Yeah.
Let's move. Oh, already off the bat, there's someone right here. Okay. We're moving. I do have to say also, the soundtrack for this game is incredible. Nah, he's already up top, is he? Come on, buddy. I don't want to have to chase you, but I might have to. Oop. Here you go. And you can, like, jet to the side. Let's see. Catch this guy. Where is he? So, yeah. Pretty good. Oh, and then there's these drops of armor, ammo, and just straight cash. These little guys with the green health bars, they can't really do any damage. They're not really smart. But you can get you some, just a little bit extra cash. Damn, guy. Oh. Okay. Yeah. You got me good there, buddy. Oh, there's a guy. Oh, yeah, there is optical camouflage as well. So, there are different, and if you're hit, your optical camouflage disappears. So, that guy can see his little bar. There we go. I must have hit him to knock that optical camouflage off. So you see those 4 little green bars, that's my ammunition that are on left and right, corresponding to different weapons. So yeah, I'm doing okay here. It is just the entrance exam. I don't think I get money for this, so there's really no point in blowing those dusters. I just gotta find the actual opponents. This is actually, that's why I like New York server here. This is a pretty good strat. Just coming up top here. And here is someone. Oh, I already scrapped you. I don't need you. Get out of here. Okay. Cool. Let's find somebody we haven't killed yet. Okay. somebody there. There you are. Get back. Hey, get back here. No, you can't escape. There we go. Who else? And don't get hit from behind. Because you take massive damage if you're hit from behind. I guess that's the boss. We must have defeated our five. Embryo. Alright. I am not above lane tactics when it comes to this sort of stuff because it can be tough. Ooh, I didn't want that. Those gift boxes do eventually disappear, so you want to grab them pretty quick. I am going to go up top. See what we can find. I want to make sure I don't get snuck up on by that guy. Because this is not a very strong mech. And you already see I'm out of a lot of ammo. So let's find out where he is. Who's that? Is that him? There he is. I'm gonna wait for him to come over here, I think. I don't want to get in the crossfire of the other mechs. Could also use some more ammo. Someone's got a lock on me. Yeah, see, those are the yellow bar dudes. I don't need to deal with them. I just want the one red bar boss dude. Awesome. Is that it? Just running along the front there. And there are different. Yeah, there he is. There are different weapons that do different things to, say, optical camouflage. Like grenades are really good for removing optical camouflage. Do not want him behind me. There we go. Just took him down. Now I just need to get out of here. Quick. There we go. Go out the gate, and we're done. Yeah, the entry exam is actually pretty easy. As you can see, they give you a vehicle. I don't think it's any better than the others, but they're not typically very intelligent. But it gets much more difficult later on. So, any edge you can get is very helpful. Check in your garage. I'm now a pro, apparently. Check in Hardwired to play. Cool. So yeah, so that's a bit of an idea. It's pretty fast-paced. You can get a bit more maneuverable. I haven't played this game in probably a decade, so I'm gonna get a little better controlling. Somebody has something to say. But yeah, pretty slick. Congrats on your pro license. I'm not a big shot. Don't wait all your crypto credits and wind up with a crappy rental. Yeah. SV Hangar, where you can assemble your SV and choose your chips. You ought to visit Data Mnemonic to save all your records. Yeah. Before you go, let me tell you a little bit. I don't... Third place is Lynx and Helix. Hell from New York. So that's the first one I'm probably going to have to beat. Next up, Hot Rod and Monkey. Yeah, so the different chips have different animals. And I think my favorite is the fox or the wolf. They're pretty balanced and suit my preferred style best. First ranker is Bokken. Yeah. So, a cool thing, this is actually something way back from Phantom Crash that if you rotate your analog stick while you're just sitting here, you rise up and you earn money. Specifically, 1,110, and you can do that once per day. Yeah, so what I'm going to do now, I could go to the Mechanist. I'm going to turn down music. The soundtrack is very good, but it also can be a little bit overpowering. So, we'll do that. Give that a try for this first episode, and I might adjust things for the next. So yeah, might as well save over here, and I'm gonna save over one of my files. Gonna be this little one. No, I'm gonna do this one. Save slot 3. Yeah, so the last one I hit 70 hours in is spent a lot of time. Right, so if I go to the Machinist, I think has used scoot vehicles, and that's usually the best way to start. Yeah, and so they'll come with weapons and legs and cores and things like that, but you can also buy them a la carte individually. So there's Hartman, which is a big, heavy, and usually slow, but heavily armored. It's more like a tank. There's Caro, which is my favorite, which is kind of medium to lightweight, very fast, and has some good modules for it. Jumps pretty good. Jumps well. Zwerg is kind of halfway between the two. It's a medium to heavyweight, and I don't really use Zwerg all that much, but there are rumbles that are limited to just one model, and these are all from different manufacturers. I believe Hartman's supposed to be American, Caro is Japanese, Zwerg is German, Proton is either Japanese or Chinese, I'm not sure, and it's the ultralight, it's the flea super light model. It's fast but very little armor. And the KHT is supposed to be Russian, and it's medium weight, but has a lot of long range capabilities. So it's meant for more of a sniper, and I'm definitely much more of an up close kite scrapper type. So look, I can get a Caro for 80,000, 79,000. I don't really like a lot of the parts on it. So instead, and you can buy individuals, so you can buy the body, leg, everything like that separate. The decals and paints to customize them. And then options are like internal things like generators that allow you to power your optical camouflage or various other things. But one thing in here, on little models just for fun, so all these generators, things like that. Peridot, you know, so they're stock. Solid state and Ventuno. So stable versus ambitious, which means high risk, high reward, or more consistent. And those prices aren't terribly great. So what I am going to do is wait a couple of days. Basically, if Ventuno is under 5,000, it's a pretty good time to buy. And if it's over 7,000, it's a pretty good time to sell. And then for solid state, if it's under 9,000, is a good time to buy. And if it's over like 15,000, I think, maybe 14,000, 15,000 is a good time to sell solid state. So this one definitely costs more, but you can make more in the long run. So what I'm going to do is go back. I know this is kind of a lame way to start, but it will allow me to get a bit better of a scoot vehicle right off the bat, a little bit a little more fun right off the bat as well. I spend a little bit of time investing in getting the money to buy the parts that you're actually going to use rather than just dealing with something substandard off the bat. I have a problem with dogs, do you? Oh, right. People think you're some kind of shady character if you whisper like that. Smiling, you're irresistible. Right. Irresistible is the word I was looking for. I don't see how to say that. Honestly, sometimes you baffle. Definitely seems dodgy, boss. We can leave talk mode and ignore him if you want. They're gonna leave talk mode and split. Jeez. Warn me. How dare you blow off this 24-year-old beauty and her smile? Well, I don't know if that's you. That's just your avatar, right? After I spent all my cash on... Yeah, the persona. Supposed to be relaxing, can't give up. Hold you wired, here's responsible, you know. I guess we'd better listen. Didi, she's a blogger. Okay, great. All kinds of bloggers, but I'm basically like a freelance journalist. Aren't we all? Look me up online if you need details. She's in debt. Great. Journalist in debt. Make a long story short, we're starting a serial documentary. Looking, talking about wireheads. And they think we're big news. Yep, so I just have to answer some questions, right? You really have no choice. The 127th team we've asked, the other 126 said no. Holy cow. 5 hours, 21 minutes. You owe 5 million new yen? I wonder how much that's worth. Don't leave me in the lurch, I'm begging. Totally at the end of my rope here. Yeah, we'll help, yeah. Okay, so we're just gonna, like, keep her posted about how well we're doing. They're gonna follow along on our journey. It's kind of like the guy in Pokemon that's at every gym. He's like, hey, champ in the making. The key to staying alive is knowing when to pull out. Yeah, I already said that. So, it's not even gonna let us enter a rumble because we don't have a Scoovy. Yeah, you do not have a link to SVP. So what I'm going to do, so you can see the schedule, we'll do that first. So there's different class rankings, and you need to beat everybody, including the ranker, or like the kind of gatekeeper, of one class before you can move up to the next. So class D is the lowest. And then once you beat everybody in there, you can go to C. Sorry about that. You can go to C, C to B, B to A. And then there's free is anyone can go in. And then challenge is something special. There's a limitation like caterpillar or hover leg modules only. Or 2, 4, and 6 legged SVs. That'd be the opposite there. And then eventually you're going to get like master rank, which is if you beat everyone up through A, then you can challenge the best of the best. These ones I don't really care for, where you can only use 2 weapons, but everyone else has the same disadvantage. And E-chip, which is the lowest basic chip. And that the chips basically just help you with aiming, with processing, and better chips or different will give you different advantages depending on what they are. So we'll go to the next day. I love that chime. So we're gonna do this for a couple days. Just gonna back out, climb to the top just to earn a little bit extra cash so that I can buy more stock. and then go back. And I'll just do this until I think, if I remember correctly, day 4 has the best prices for Ventuno stock. So I'll just show you how that's bought, and then I'll skip the rest, or time-lapse it, just because it's gonna get a little tedious. Yeah. And I think we'll round out this episode with buying the parts for the Scooby that I really like. I might make some more, but I really like the Caro with a particular loadout that I remember. So this is... Oh, this is day 4. Mine. So we're gonna go. Good thing I checked it. So we're gonna go to the Machinist. And we're gonna buy. It should be. Yeah. 4,664, so that's pretty good. So I'm going to buy as many of these as I can. So that's as much as I can get. I have a bunch. Don't know exactly how many I have. Let's see. A bunch. All of those. I don't want to sell it at 4,664 though, so I'm going to skip ahead a few days, continuing to stack up as we go. And I'll see you on the other side then. Alright, and sure, that was a little bit tedious, just to give you an idea of what we're in for. So now, the price for Ventuno stock is 7,022, which is pretty great. Not quite twice as much, but definitely will help us out. So let's get to that. Alright, so we sold all of them, and I see we have not twice as much, but pretty good amount more. And so now, we don't have anything, right? We sold all our mods. But I want a little more. So, what we're gonna do is go to the next day, and the next day, solid state stock should then be a pretty good price. And from now on, I am not going to. This will be one last spiral into the sky, because it's worth 1,110 credits each time I do it. But with the amount of money we're getting from playing the stock market, it really isn't going to matter much. After this one, you know, it's not really worth it. Yeah. If we were playing, not legitimately, but if we were playing just going right off the bat without playing the stock market at all, it'd probably be more important to do that. But, yeah, so solid state's now at 8805, so we'll just buy a bunch of this. Alright, and since that was significantly more expensive, it went a lot faster to use up all my money. And I think, So we're just going to skip forward a few days. Quite a few days. And then see you on the other side. Alright, welcome back. That was an ordeal. It took a little bit longer than I was expecting. I decided to go through, as you can see up there on the top left, went to day 97. Part of the reason is this game, to its credit, it doesn't really hold your hand. There's very little in terms of background, doesn't really tell you the lore, doesn't really tell you what you're supposed to do. It kind of thrusts you into it and you pick things up as you go along. There's a little bit. You can go to the battle school and learn more as you go, but it doesn't require you to, and I actually appreciate that. So it doesn't tell you that there are stocks that you can buy and sell and trade, so I wanted to try it this way. And you can see up there at the top, I now have over 3 million credits. I'm going to leave the time lapse of that up on the top right. If you're interested, and I'll just do the time lapse of my credits so you can see them fluctuate up and down. If anyone's interested, I can leave the. I made a smart sheet, or a Google Sheets for all of the different prices of the two different stocks available and their different days, and they go in a 100-day cycle. So this is just about the near of one complete cycle. So if you did exactly what I did and you did the spinning your analog stick around to get the extra 1,000 for the first few days, and then just skip days between buying and selling, you'll end up with about this amount. So we don't need to go and slum it here, so I'll just go through it since it doesn't explain. You have hardwired, which is where you do your rumbling. It also allows you to skip days. Your hangar is where you'll adjust your scoot vehicles, your mechs, and what parts you have on them. Mechanist is kind of the secondhand market you can buy and sell stuff. It's the main place you're going to buy modules, parts for your mech. Edgeworks is for upgrading. You can balance your parts. So if you get a weapon, say like a cannon, and you want it to be more powerful, you can customize it so it has more power, but at the cost of it being heavier or having less ammo, stuff like that. Difference is where you buy chips, which will replace this guy here, where we'll start. You can buy music to play alongside your rumbling and tune it to your preferences. So if you only want to play Zebrahead, that's what you can do. Idle is where we're going to buy our new persona. Data mnemonic is the save services and options. And then you have Beamport, which is where you can go to the different hubs. Like, we're in Liberties right now, which is in New York. And they're, as we saw at the beginning, you can choose which one of the, I believe, seven you want to go to. They also, it costs money to move. You personally don't move because you're just virtually there, but it has to move your scoot vehicle, your mech, to one of those different areas in order to battle. Battle school is obviously where the information is. And then these five are the manufacturers of the SVs. And I think I'm mistaken, I'll amend what I said earlier. The Caro, which is made by Ventuno, I believe is supposed to be Italian in game, not Japanese. The Kojima, which makes the Super Light Proton, is Japanese. So Omsk, and the KHT is, I guess, light, they consider lightweight, and it's one that's more geared toward long range. Ventuno, kind of scrappy mid range. So on like that. So we'll actually go. First, I want to go and get a new chip and see what they have. Now, the offerings for these stores differ day to day as well, and so you're kind of beholden to that. So let's see what we've got. So we've got a bird, and you can see some numbers there. Life points are pretty similar, but on the left is what's really important, and those two ranges really dictate the style the chip is best geared for. So a bird here, you see it's taps, which is kind of lock on. Auto aim is really small reticle in the middle, and the lock on range is really wide, so that would benefit if you have a good vantage point over over the battlefield. Dog is reversed. See, it has more of a square lock-on range and a little bit bigger of an auto-aim range, so it's better for mid-range balanced. Cat is very wide range, field of view. Probably won't do very well long distance. But yeah, wide field of view. Penguin's another one. So wolf, I think, is what we're going to go with. Horse, actually horse is pretty good too. Bear, yeah, it's got a tall viewport, so if you're using swords or things like that. Turtle is defensive and wide range. Pig. But we'll start with the wolf, and what you can do is they will level up, and you can transfer them to another chip. So once we find Fox, I'll do that. Writes your chip. Data written. And then we'll have a little cutscene. Oh, wolf two. So let's name him. What are we gonna name him? Let's name him Kang. Speedy Rocket, right? You are very discerning, choosing me over other chips. Yes, I am. So we've got our chip. Yeah, and so you can. The chips will take some damage during a rumble, hopefully not too much, because if they cease to function, there's a lot you can do. You can repair them a little bit, but it will continue to degrade, and eventually you'll have to transfer to a new chip. So that's our chip. Let's pick a new persona, because we're narcissistic and superficial like that. And there's different classes of them. We've got the low-tech, which is what we have, this wireframe look with these polygon fighters. The readout is, I never really like these, they're kind of swirly, don't really care for them. There's puppet, which is kind of neat, kind of have these, you know, early PlayStation polygon type vibes. I don't know, the deep sea diver's kind of funny, I don't like that. And then there's Edge, which are the most realistic ones. I'm gonna go with that deep sea diver. That looks fun. Let's do that. Okay. And now, the most important part, which is getting our SV. And let's see what. I know I want a Karo. We'll eventually have one of each of these, but I like Karo. Suits me. Yeah, Il Vecchino Gruppo. It's gotta be. So let's see what we've got. So these ones are gonna be out the box, ready to go. They've got all their parts. They'll be great. If you buy from the machinist, there might have a piece missing. They might have not have all four weapons or some other parts missing. And not really be ideal, but they're cheaper. But since we have the money, let's see what we've got. So I don't really use the melee, so that pile driver right hand isn't going to be too good for me. And I don't really, I mean, the grenades are all right, but I prefer to use like machine guns or something to break optical camouflage. So that'd be okay. Six legs, spider legs, maybe. That has some interesting parts, but you know what? I'm gonna see what we can get individually. So let's go back to the Mechanist. And that way you can just buy them individually. I think it's a bit more expensive to buy them individually, but at least you get only what you want. Well, let's see what we've got for SV. So, KHT. So Karo, yeah, see it's missing its arm module there, and it has two arm modules are missing, and it has two grenade launchers, so that's not great, but it's cheap. This is where you'd normally get your SV if you didn't basically scum your way through the stocks. Yeah, alright, well, let's see what we got. Buy a Karo. Oh, it's heavy one. Oh, yeah, so... See, down below the part picture there, it says normal, zero. That's what I was talking about, the customization. So a heavy one means it's got more carrying capacity, but a little bit less speed, normal. And then this one is light one, so it's the opposite. It's faster, but less armor points. So we're gonna get this Caro. And then we'll get legs. Let's see what Caro legs are available. Two legs, perfect. Those are my favorite ones. Let's do that. And they have different pros and cons. Like legs, I think, can jump higher, but wheels are generally faster. So let's see what weapons are available. I don't really care for pile driver, and we only have those two as options, which are not great. Might as well get. Let's see. Either that or it's waiting for the next day and see what they have. Well, we'll be alright. We'll make do. There we go. That's what I want. Let's see. So this is a missile launcher, this is a grenade launcher, and this is a big gun. So I want two of those, actually. Perfect. I feel better about not finding the ideal handheld weapons. Because there are some weapons that are really rare, like they don't really show up all that often in here, but they might show up on a complete unit that you buy from the manufacturer. And if I remember correctly, there's also a it's also like a black market. Maybe I'm misremembering. So first thing we need is optical camouflage. So I think I like the balanced one best. So this one recovers much faster, and this one recovers much faster and has a short runtime. This one is very light. You'll see those numbers up there. But yeah, I'm just gonna get this regular one. And you can stack them, so you can get a couple of them, depending on how many option sockets you have. So let's see. See what we can put in here. Like, this will add some armor points. Don't need any stock. Taps. Sure. Let's get that. Let's get the reinforced window. That's a little bit more health. And giant heat sink. Oh, that just improves the optical camouflage. Okay, let's see about that paint. Anything look good in here? Maybe eventually I'll play with this customization here. But for now, this is kind of nice. Let's do that. And decals. That doesn't look good with it. Look at the flaming number 9, sure. Alright, let's put it together and see what we look like. And I think I'll end the video off there once we get this thing complete. Assemble our SV in here. It's gonna be the Caro Heavy 1 body. Yep, it's imperfect, it doesn't have anything. Normal legs. We're gonna put both these machine guns on here, and both of these machine guns on here. Cool. Put in the OC generator, coprocessor. How many slots do I have? So I have all of those. Okay, I have 5 socket holes. There we go. And all 5 are used up. Great. Where do I want it? Front and back? Sure, why not? And where do I put paint? Back here. Oh, I know. I have to put the paint on when I buy it. Oh, it's overweight. Oh no. So I'm gonna have to probably increase the legs support. Come on. Oh, I think I know what's up. So I need to not only assemble my SVU, but also link it, so that's the one that my body or whatever is in. Link to SVU, yeah, that's what I thought. So I'm going to have to go to the customization place and increase the weight of the legs that they can support the weight of the weapons that I just put on there. Let's paint it. Now will it show up? There we go. So, that looks pretty good. This one might be... Tiger stripes? Oh, never mind. I like the tiger stripes. Let's do that. Alright. Well, that's all we can do here. Don't really care for these weapons too much, but they'll have to do. And I think... I see that starter chip guy is there, so I'm gonna have to go into the chip place. Let's customize. Okay, so this is where I can use this. So customize legs, and I want to make them a bit heavier. I don't even need to make them that much heavier. So I know the weapons that I'm going to get are substantially heavier than the weapons that I want. Are going to be heavier than what I have currently, so let's prepare for that. Yeah. And then I do need to go in the chip place and set up a new one. Just a lot of little busy work, but then we'll get rumbling and just wipe the floor with them. Yeah, so this one's equipped, is indestructible, has infinite life points, but not great anything else. You will be my escort then, of course. I don't expect you to lose, understood? Absolutely, sir. Okay, and that's it, we're good to go. So, I guess, yes, it will rumble. And again, I'll leave off. We won't do the rumble this episode. I'll do it in the next one. But that's right where we'll start. And it is Class D. Yeah, so if we check this schedule. Class D, I can't do tomorrow's, so... Or the next one. So we might go to another location. Like, we might go Hong Kong. And battle there, because I can't battle in B until I beat everyone in D, and I can't do that. I don't think I can do that on my first run, but we'll certainly try. Certainly not with these weapons. Alright, well, that'll do it for now. Thank you for watching and bearing with me during this. It was not the most exciting first episode, but laying the groundwork for great things to come. We've still got, you know, 2.5 million credits, so we should be able to buy whatever we want. Alright, take it easy.